हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम नगमा बी फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स डिपार्टमेंट्स ऑफ रविनाथ टैगोर यूनिवर्सिटी भोपाल. टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द ट्रांसफार्मर. नाउ गो टू द इंट्रोडक्शंस, कंस्ट्रक्शंस, टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांसफार्मर, वर्किंग एंड प्रिंसिपल, ईएमएफ इक्वेशन. लास्ट वन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द फेजर डायग्राम अंडर नो लोड कंडीशन. नाउ फर्स्ट वी गो टू द इंट्रोडक्शंस. व्हाट इज द ट्रांसफार्मर? Transformer is a static device which transfer power from one circuit to another circuit without change any frequency. Here, first question is arise, why transformer is called static device? Because in a transformer, there is no rotating parts are present. That's why the transformer is called the static device. In a transformer, there is no electrical connection between the primary and secondary. In a transformer, the power is transmitted from one circuit to another circuit through the magnetic flux. By using the transformer, we can transmit the power in a transmission line during the generation, transmission and distributions. Simply, we can say in a transformer, the power must be same, frequency must be same, but voltage level can change. Now, next one is construction. What is the construction of the transformer? Basically, transformer consists of two winding, primary winding and secondary winding and magnetic core. Now, how we will decide which winding is primary and secondary? When the winding is connected to the source side, that is a primary winding. When winding is connected to the load side, that is a secondary winding. Now, next one is magnetic core. What is the magnetic core? The magnetic core in a transformer look like rectangular as shown in figure. The main working of core, which is provides a path for passing the flux. When the maximum flux will passes this core, there are two types of losses that will occur inside the core. Those losses are also known as hysteresis losses and eddy current losses. Now, how we can to minimize these losses? The core is made up of thin lamination. That is to reduce the eddy current losses. Two, this lamination provides by CRG material, that is a core roar grain oriented silicone steel. Now, how we can to minimize this hysteresis losses? The core is made up of high grade silicone steel. Why we choose this material? Because this material has a high permeability. Now, next go to the types of transformer. There are many types of transformer used according to constructions, according to turns ratio, according to windings, and according to power system application, etc. Now, first we go to the according to constructions. There are two types of transformer used according to constructions, core type transformer and shell type transformer. In a core type transformer, the core surrounds the winding as shown in figure, whereas in shell type transformer, the winding surrounds the core. In a core type transformer, which has a two windings are used, whereas in shell type transformer has a three windings are used. In a core type transformer, two windings are used. Due to this reason, there is only one magnetic path are provides for passing the flux, whereas in shell type transformer has a three windings are used. Due to this reason, there are two magnetic path are provides for passing the flux. Now, next one is according to turns ratio. There are two types of the transformer used according to turns ratio, step up transformer and step down transformer. Now, in case of step up transformer, the transformer is designed to increase the voltage from primary to secondary, that is known as step up transformer. In other words, we can say the number of turns secondary winding is more than the primary winding, is also known as step up transformer. Now, next is step down transformer. In case of step down transformer, the transformer designed to decrease the voltage from primary to secondary, that is known as step down transformer. In other words, we can say the number of turns on secondary side is less than that of primary winding, is also known as step down transformer. Now, next go to the according to supply. There are two types of the transformer used, single phase transformer and three phase transformer. Now, next one is according to power system applications. There are two transformer used according to power system applications, power transformer and distribution transformer. Power transformer, which is used for high transmission line, that is a very high rating transformer. And next one is distribution transformer, which is used for distribution network, that is a low rating as compared to power transformer. Now, next one is instrumentation transformer. There are two types of the transformer used, current transformer and potential transformer. What are transformer used for in a transmission line? The current transformer, which is used for measurement of current in a transmission line, and then the potential transformer, which is used for measurement of high voltage in a transmission line. Now, next go to the working of principle of the transformer. Now, basically, transformer works on the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic inductions. When we noted the transformer has a two winding, primary winding and secondary winding. When the alternating voltage applied to the primary side, then alternating current flow in the primary side. Due to this current, the alternating flux set up in the core. This flux link with the primary winding as well as secondary winding. Then EMF induced in the primary winding as well as secondary winding according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Now the EMF induced we can write as E equals to minus N d phi by dt. Here the minus sign indicates that the EMF induced voltage opposes the supply voltage according to Lange's law. Now in case of transformer, the EMF induced statically, not dynamically. If we talk about the generator and the motor, there is a EMF induced dynamically. There are two types of EMF induced according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic inductions, statically and dynamically. Statically, that means the conductor does not change in position, but flux will change. That is, for example, in a transformer, the winding is fixed, the flux will change in position. That means the EMF induced is a statically according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. If we talk about the generator and the motor, there is a rotating parts are present. That is a rotor. Rotor is a rotating parts. It means, for example, whenever the conductor plays in a magnetic field, the conductor moves, the conductor cut the magnetic lines of force, then EMF induced. This type of EMF induced is also known as dynamically induced EMF according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic inductions. Now next go to the EMF equation of the transformer. Now how much voltage induced in the primary winding and how much voltage induced in the secondary winding, we can draw the EMF equation of the transformer. We now did according to principle, when alternating voltage applied to the primary side, then alternating current flow in the primary winding, then alternating flux set up in the core. That means the voltage is also alternating in nature, the current is also alternating in nature, and flux is also alternating in nature. Now we draw the flux waveform of the flux. Now we draw the alternating flux waveform. The sinusoidal flux can be represented by as phi equals to phi m sin omega t. We know that the EMF induced in the primary as well as secondary winding E equals to minus of N d phi by dt, where N is the number of turns in the primary winding and as well as secondary winding. Now we know that phi equals to phi m sin omega t. The put the equation in equation first, phi equals to phi m sin omega t. The equation we can write, we will get E equals to minus of N d by dt phi m sin omega t. Now after that we find out the derivative of sin omega t. Now the derivative of the sin omega t is omega cos omega t. Now we will get E1 equals to minus N1 phi m omega cos omega t, where omega is angular frequency. Now the angular frequency in we can write in terms of frequency 2 pi f. Now the next equation we can write minus N1 phi m 2 pi f cos omega t. We know that minus of cos omega t is equals to sin omega t minus of 90 degree. Now put the in equation, next equation, then we will get minus of 2 pi f N1 phi m sin omega t minus of 90 degree. For maximum EMF, sin omega t minus 90 degree should be equal to the primary winding of the EMF induced voltage. That is, the maximum EMF induced 2 pi f N1 phi m. Now, the RMS value of the EMF induced in the primary winding we can write as E maximum divided by root 2. Now, the equation we can be divided by root 2. Then we will get the equation 4.44 f n1 and phi m, where f is the frequency N1 is the number of turns and 5 is the maximum flux used in the voltage. Now, next go to the ideal transformer. The transformer which is free from all the types of losses, that is known as ideal transformer. The ideal transformer has no winding resistance, that is the output voltage should be equal to the input voltage. No leakage flux, that is the same flux link both the winding. No iron losses. Simply we can say the ideal transformer cannot be physically realized. Now next one is phasor diagram or no load. Consider an ideal transformer. The secondary side is open circuited. According to principle, when alternating voltage applied to the primary side, their alternating current, that is a magnetizing current, flow in the primary side, which is a magnetizing current, which is lag behind the applied voltage by 90 degree. Why 90 degree? Because the secondary side is open circuited. The coil of the primary winding is pure inductance. That means the magnetizing current is lag behind the applied voltage by 90 degree, as shown in phasor diagram. The current is also alternating nature, then flux is also alternating nature. Current is flow, then due to this current, the alternating flux is also set up in the core. Both are in draw the same phases. Now, we note it, when alternating flux link with the primary winding as well as secondary winding, then EMF induced primary winding as well as secondary winding according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Both are EMF induced, E1 and E2, lags behind the flux by 90 degree. Because the EMF induced in the primary winding as well as secondary winding according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic inductions. I hope you understand. We have already learned about the introductions, constructions, types of transformer, working principle and EMF equations. I will continue next session. Thank you.